अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द वेलोसिटी ट्राइंगल ऑफ अ स्टीम टर्बाइन. स्टूडेंट्स, फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस लैब. द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस लैब इज़ टू अंडरस्टैंड द इनलेट एंड आउटलेट वेलोसिटी ट्राइंगल ऑफ अ स्टीम टर्बाइन एंड टू प्लॉट द वेलोसिटी ट्राइंगल ऑफ अ स्टीम टर्बाइन इन मैट लैब. इन थेरी पार्ट स्टूडेंट्स, इन क्लास वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड द इनलेट एंड आउटलेट वेलोसिटी ट्राइंगल ऑफ स्टीम टर्बाइन एंड हेयर in the lab we will again discuss it in detail and then we will plot these triangle inlet and outlet velocity triangle in MATLAB. So first coming towards that, what is actually the steam turbine? You all know that the steam turbine is one of the heat engine in which the steam heat energy is converted into the mechanical work. The construction of steam turbine is very simple. It consists of a rotor and set of a rotating blades which are attached to a shaft, and shaft is placed in the middle of the rotor. An electrical generator known as steam turbine generator is connected to a rotor shaft, and the turbine generator collects the mechanical energy from the shaft and converts it into the electrical energy. Now coming towards the working principle. The working principle of steam turbine depends on the dynamic action of the steam, and a high velocity steam is coming from the nozzle and it strikes the rotating blade which are fitted on a disc mounted on a shaft. The high velocity steam produces the dynamic pressure on the blade in which the blade and shaft both rotates in the same direction. Basically, in steam turbine, the pressure energy of a steam extracts and then converted into kinetic energy by allowing the steam to flow through the nozzle. The conversion of kinetic energy does mechanical work to the rotor blades, and rotor is connected to steam turbine generator which act as a mediator. The turbine generator collects mechanical energy from rotor and converts it into the electrical energy. Since the construction of steam turbine is very simple, its vibration is much simpler than the other engines for same rotating speed. Though different types of governing systems are used to improve the turbine speed, according to the working principle, the speed turbines are mainly divided into two categories, that is the impulse turbine and the reaction turbine. The basic difference between the impulse turbine and the reaction turbine is very simple. In case of the impulse turbine, the steam strikes the moving blade through nozzle, whereas in case of the reaction turbine, the steam strikes the moving blades under pressure via guided mechanism. Therefore, in this lab, we will discuss only the impulse turbine, and we will draw the velocity triangle of the impulse turbine in MATLAB. Now coming towards the velocity triangle of the steam turbine. Here, students, you can see that first we will draw the inlet velocity triangle of a steam turbine, and then we will draw the outlet velocity triangle, and at the end we will draw the combined inlet and outlet velocity triangle. So first coming towards the inlet velocity triangle, so here you can see that in the inlet velocity triangle, you can see that the blade is moving with the velocity u. When the blade is moving with the velocity u, the steam jet coming out of the nozzle with velocity v1, it strikes the blade at point B. So AB represents the velocity v1. When the jet moves with the velocity v1, it is striking the blade with some angle, and you can see here that it is striking with an angle alpha, and v1 is having the two components, that is AD component and BD component, and we will discuss in detail these two components in next slides. Students, now you can see here that first, you know that the V1 is the absolute velocity which is inclined at angle alpha, and jet is striking the blade with this velocity V1. Now, because of this input velocity V1, the blade moves with the velocity U, which is drawn here at the AC component. So, this AC component represents the blade velocity U1. Now, students, draw the line from point C to B. You will get the relative velocity VR1. So, relative velocity can be found out by subtracting the blade velocity from the absolute velocity. You will get the relative velocity, and this relative velocity also have two components, BD and CD. You can see here that BD is actually the flow velocity at the inlet side. So we have represented it with VF1, and VW1 is actually the point A to D, that is the real velocity VW1. So if you want to find this CD component, you can subtract VW1 minus U1, then you will get this component CD. We will do this in numerical section. Now coming towards the outlet velocity triangle. In outlet velocity triangle, as you have already seen, that when steam is moving with velocity V1 and it is striking the blade at this point B, then it flows over the blade from here and we get the component of output velocity. Now steam get after striking the blade with velocity V1, the steam glides over from the point E to G and it discharges with the relative velocity, that is VR2. So VR2 here is inclined with an angle phi. So here blade velocity U2 is represented by the component G to F. Now from drawing a line from point E to F, after drawing the line from point E to F, we get our absolute velocity V2 at that, which is the outlet velocity. So students, you can see here that point, this output velocity has some, is inclined with an angle beta. So you can see here that V2 is also have two components, that is real velocity VW2, that is from, we have the component FH, and HE or EH represent the flow velocity at the outlet side, that is VF2. Now for the numerical section, it is necessary to combine the both inlet and outlet velocity triangles. So in this case, we will discuss in detail the combined velocity triangle. So the segment ML here represents the blade velocity U, which is equal to U1 and U2. So we have drawn this line segment here. First we will draw the inlet velocity triangle. So inlet velocity triangle is represented here by PLS. So this is our inlet velocity triangle, and in the next slide you can see here that NQN represents the output or outlet velocity triangle, and the suffix 1 represent the inlet values and suffix 2 represent the output values, that is the outlet values. Now coming towards the task, what we have to do in the task here, that you can see that in steam power plant, the steam come out of the nozzle with the velocity of 1200 meter per second and the nozzle angle is 20 degree. The mean blade velocity is 400 meter per second, and the mass of the steam flowing per hour is 1000 kilograms, whereas the blade velocity coefficient is given, that is 0.8. you have to draw in MATLAB the combined velocity triangle. So coming towards the MATLAB, in the task you can see here easily that here actually we have given the 400 meters square per second is our U, that is the blade velocity. V1 is also given, that is the steam coming out of the nozzle with velocity V1, and this V1 is 1200 meter per second. Alpha is also given here, that is 20 degrees, and mass of the steam flowing is also given, this is in per hour, and blade coefficient velocity K is also given. So we will write all these values here. For this we will add a new script, and then we will write the values here. U is given, that is 400. Next we are given V1, that is 1200, and K is given, that is 0.8, and alpha is given. We will write alpha as A is equal to 20 degrees. Next students, now coming towards again towards our slides, and here in the velocity triangle we will only see the inlet velocity triangle first. In the inlet velocity triangle, you can see here that we are given U1, V1, and this alpha angle. Now you can see here that VW1 is actually that the cause here V1 is given. So VW1 is the cause component of this V1 and VF1 is the sine component of this V1. So if we write V1 cos alpha, we will get VW1, and if we write V1 sine alpha, we will get VF1. So we will write this code in MATLAB as VW1. You can see that VW1 is the cos component of V1. So we will write it as V1 steric cosine dt of alpha, and for flow velocity it can be written as the sine component. So here we will write it like this. After writing this, again coming towards the triangle, we have already discussed that if you want to find this CD, then this CD component can be found out by subtracting VW1 minus U1, by subtracting the U1 velocity, that is the velocity of the blade, from the vril velocity. So we will write it in the MATLAB, we will name it as VW1, or CD component is VW1. So we will find VW1 as VW1 minus U1. So you will get VW1. Students, actually the reason of finding this CD, that is CD, we have named it as VW1, because we want to find the relative velocity VR1. So if we know this component and we have already find out this component, we can find out VR1. You can know the mathematical form that hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus perpendicular square. So hypotenuse VR1 can be find out as VR1 is equal to this CD, that is VW1 square plus VF1 square and whole square root. So we will write this formula in MATLAB as VR1, the relative velocity, is equal to VW1 square plus, we will write VF1 square, and we will square root of this. Sorry, here we have an error. We have to write it like this. Okay, we have find out the relative velocity. Now if you want to find the relative velocity at point 2, then we will multiply the k with our relative velocity at inlet, that VR1 is multiplied with the coefficient k, then we will get the relative velocity at outlet. If you know the inlet velocity, you will multiply it with the coefficient and you will get the relative velocity at outlet. This will also be find out. Now again coming towards our outlet triangle. So students, here if you know this beta angle, you can easily find out the wheel velocity VW2 and VF2, because VW2 is equal to the relative velocity into the cosine of, you can here see that this VR2 is known. So if you multiply it with the cosine component, you will get VW2, and if you multiply it with the VR2 with sine component, you will get VF2. So this is actually the cosine component of VR2 and this is actually the sine component of VR2. Likewise, we have already find out these two in the inlet velocity triangle. So student, we have to find this angle beta. So this angle beta can be find out by using the tan angle, that is tan of VF1 divided by VW1 into this alpha angle, then you will get this beta. So we will write it in the MATLAB as T is equal to alpha into tan D of VF1, we have already find out this, and VW1 is also calculated, so we will get T. After the getting the T, we have already discussed that we can find out VW2 as VR2 into cosine of T and V F2 can be find out as VR2 sine component of VR2, that is sine V T. So we have written the code here. Okay students, now the last one, what we have to do in the last, we have written the, we have to plot x and y component, and now we have to write these x and y components here. So for x component you will write 0 comma u comma minus pw1 0 vw2 and u. And for y component we will write it 0 comma 0 comma vf1 comma 0 comma vf2 comma 0. Actually you have to remind the velocity triangles. You can see here that first you have to draw the origin, x is 0, y axis is also 0, then from next point you have a u, that is the blade velocity, and here the y component is 0. You can see in the figure here that you have to draw 0 0, that is x is axis 0, y is 0, then here we have x is u and y is 0. So we have plotted x component as u and y as 0. Then next we have draw the bw1, that is this component, this is bw1, and we have drawn it in the reverse form, that is, that's why we have written minus bw1. And now in bw1 case here you can see we have a y component also. Here we have a BW1 and here y component is not 0, y component is VF1, therefore we have plotted here VF1. Now next we have to draw the outlet triangle. So again we come towards the origin 0 0, and in this case we have next VW2, the wheel velocity at outlet, and at that point we have a flow velocity component on the y side. So we have written VF2. And at the end again we will get the blade velocity u, and here the y component will be 0. So we have plot x comma y. Now we will run this code. Okay students, now we will run the code. You can see that code is running, and here we get the inlet and outlet velocity triangle. These are our inlet and outlet velocity triangle, and this is our output velocity, VF2, flow velocity and wheel velocity, because we didn't put the semicolon here, therefore they are given as the values. So you have to do the lab task 2, which is given here in the slides. Task 2 is given, is also given in your manual. So you have to perform the lab task 2 as an home assignment. Okay students, Allah Hafiz.